John Oliver's English, right?
Yes.
So he hasn't Skyped me, but hey, American Idol has a produce. Okay, sorry. I got John Oliver. Let me start all over.
Uh-oh.
John, you're off to the side right now. Because American Idol has produced some amazing talent like our own Jordan Sparks. Well, I talk with Nigel Lythgoe, one of the exec producers of the Idol, who's English, about his new American Idol podcast. I am so glad to have this interview because he's making quarantine so much better with his new podcast, and it's about American Idol. I'll tell you, Nigel, this is so great that you are making people have memories of American Idol because you've created it. But this podcast, tell me a little bit more about what you're doing on it.
Well, I didn't create it. I was the executive producer of it that sort of course, helped shape it. But Simon Fuller was the creator of it, the Spice Girls manager. Bringing it here from the UK, where it was originally Pop Idol, I do the whole genesis of what inspired it to Simon Fuller, which was a program called Pop Stars in New Zealand and Australia. And then through to all of the sort of problems, the nightmares, the behind-the-scenes stories of American Idol and how it developed over the series, basically.
Yeah, and you're going through some of the past winners and also some of the past losers that have moved on in a way, which is kind of interesting because I think anybody who comes on that show is a winner, even though they don't win the grand prize. And you have a lot of great memories that you talk about on this podcast. What is one of them?
Well, many of them revolve around what was going on behind the scenes. You know, we had a lot of problems with Paula originally because she was so heartbroken at the things that Simon Cowell was saying to the kids. She'd been a performer, obviously, had had numerous rejections, like all performers get when they go to auditions, but none as harsh as was being dished out by Simon Cowell. You know, he said to one kid, "Have you got a singing teacher?" And she said, "Yes, I have." He said, "Well, sue her, get your money back, because you will never be a singer." And of course, Paula was just in tears with this, up until the point I told her that she could actually hit Simon if she didn't like what he was saying. And he, at one interview, I think, with E! Or some other program like that, turned around and said all of his ribs were bruised by being punched and elbowed by Paula. So there's lots of stories like that. Plus, you know, the fun thing is interviewing a lot of the contestants now, like Jim Vararos, Justin Guarini. In fact, today I'm going to be talking to Nikki McKibben. So, you know, I'm just dealing with season one at the moment. We've got a lot of seasons to go through. Hopefully I'll manage to do that before I pass on. it's great fun. And for me to relive all of this during this awful pandemic, it is great. It just keeps my brain alive. And I think it was Clint Eastwood that said, "Never let the old man in." And I live by that.
Yeah, and you have these, again, they were young kids now coming back and talking with you sure. About their experience. I mean, has any of them walked up to you and said, "Oh my gosh, that was the worst thing I ever do in my life?" Or they walk up and go, "Oh my gosh, that was the greatest thing I ever did in my life."
Well, if they don't hit me when they first walk up, I know they've enjoyed themselves.
So, all right, Jordan Sparks, she is our Arizona homegirl who won the title there. What can you tell us a little bit about her? Maybe some secrets that we don't know.
I haven't got that far along yet. So, no, I'm not really talking about the contestants' secrets. That's up to them if they want to talk about that. I'm talking more about the production secrets and really some of the things that happened with the judges and myself. For instance, if you've listened to the podcast, you'll know the story about when I fell asleep on an aeroplane and Simon Cowell wrote a love letter to the guy next to me, sitting next to me, and pretended it was from me. The mayhem that was caused during the flight because of that. So there's all those little intricate secrets that are going on there. Contestants, I'll let them speak for themselves.
So, since you're talking secrets, as you and executive producer and Simon and the other, of course, hosts, was there any really big tiff that you guys ever had that someone literally said, I'm not coming tomorrow?
Yes. Paula walked out a number of times and had to be talked back in. Thank goodness we had a great team. There was an American executive producer on the show called Brian Gadinsky, who was very good at man management. You know, he kept his temper a lot of the time, and that was just with me. We had an executive from Fremantle Media called Cecile Frocatas, who helped with Paula, because Paula always felt there was a boys' club in the production between Randy, Simon, myself, the other executive producer, Kenny Warwick, Ryan Seacrest, of course. But I think the biggest tiff we ever had, and if you subscribe to the podcast, you'll hear all about it, was between Randy and Simon. And Simon said something that really upset Randy, which we as Brits didn't understand why Randy got so upset. But it was a very heated argument. Randy towered over Simon's chair once and said, Do you want to take it outside? Which I know, had they have gone outside, who my money would have been on, that's for sure. But it was, you know, we had to reshoot that scene. So nobody actually saw what Simon actually said, and I reveal it on the podcast.
All right. Okay, I know I got to finish up here, and I know I'm supposed to listen to the podcast, but can you answer? I got to ask you, why'd you go from two hosts to one host? What's the truth behind that one?
The truth was we only had two hosts because that's how we made the show in the United Kingdom. And Fox didn't want anything changed from Pop Idol in the UK to American Idol. So we took on board two hosts, when really the host just pushes it along and gives us information. It didn't need two people. In the UK, we had two mates that had grown up from a very, very young age together as actors and then presenters. So they knew each other and they were like one person. Here, with taking a radio DJ and a very droll, dry comedian and putting them together, the chemistry wasn't great and it was a bit slow in pace and delivery. So we brought it down to one person. Plus, Brian Dunkelman asked to leave because his heart was breaking in absolute truth with the things that Simon was saying to these kids. And you'll hear it again on the podcast. I've actually got some of the dialogue that Brian Dunkelman said. And it was very sad, and you could understand why. His heart broke.
Wow.
So
there it is.
Between the two, that's why we ended up with Ryan Seacrest, and very happy that we did.
Look, I got the answers right there, and we can get more answers of our American Idol memories by going to your podcast, and the podcast is titled
Idol Memories.
So, perfect. Nigel, thanks for joining me, and this has been an honor. I'll tell you, I appreciate it.
Thank you very much, and I'm so happy that we can reveal to everybody that you started as a dancer.
Yes, I did. So, thank you, Nigel.